Hi, my name is Jos Overschie, passionate trainer and consultant at Ovedicon. In this video, I want to tell you more about the multi-stage pump with the following subjects. Why it's called a multi-stage pump, the parts in the multi-stage pump, how a multi-stage pump works, and also I will tell you more about some applications. But why is this pump called a multi-stage pump? In a former video, I already showed you in the working principle of the centrifugal pump that there was just one impeller in the pump. And this one, the pump that I have in front of me, is a multi-stage. When I remove the pump housing, you see different segments. 1, 2, 3, 4 segments. And in every segment, you will find an impeller. When I remove this, you see the impeller here. Also here, I have a multi-stage impeller pump part. And in every segment, basically, you will find two parts. You have the diffuser, and you have the impeller with the impeller eye. And how did this works together? I show you in the next animation. In this animation, you see a multi-stage pump, and there are 5 impellers fitted in this multi-stage pump. You find the inlet port on the left side of the animation. Here, the medium will enter the pump, and on the top, you will find the outlet, the discharge port of this multi-stage pump. If you look at the arrow on the left side, you see that the medium is entering the first impeller through the impeller eye. It goes to the outside of the impeller, and because of the diffuser, it will come to the eye of the impeller of the second impeller. And so it goes to the outside again through the diffuser in the impeller eye of the third impeller. And so it goes on and on. And when the medium is on the outside of the fifth impeller, it will come in the pump housing and it goes through the outlet to the discharge port. And you see the two colors we used, from light blue to dark blue, because the medium will get a higher pressure. The first impeller will add some energy to the medium. That energy is picked up by the second impeller. It will add some extra energy and it goes on to the fifth impeller. Therefore, we get a much more higher pressure with a multi-stage pump as we can with a one impeller pump. Therefore, we use a multi-stage pump. Now something more about two applications. One of the applications is for drinking water. And therefore, they use multi-stage pump like this one. You see them often in apartment buildings. Because of the high ends of the apartment buildings, they also need water of the right pressure. Therefore, multi-stage, because as I told you, every stage will add some energy. And be aware that always, because of the impeller, the particle size must be less than 1 millimeter. Another application is a borehole pump, and you will find a picture of a borehole pump here. I made this picture in Bangladesh, and you see 3 guys with hard hats on, and in the middle you see the pump. This pump had a length of about 3 meters, and we only see in the top three of the segments of this pump. But this pump had more than 15 segments, and in every segment you will find an impeller. The guys are now preparing the pump before we can lower it. This pump is lowered 100 meters below ground level, and it's pumping every hour 75 cubes of drinking water to the apartment buildings. If you want to know more about this project with the borehole pumps in Bangladesh, please visit our website. I hope you enjoyed this video and maybe you learned something. If you have questions, please drop them in comments below, and don't forget to subscribe. I hope to see you next time. Bye.